Christians, we know we face many spiritual battles. From the moment we are saved, we are enlisted in the army, the Lord's army, called to be good and faithful soldiers, to stand firm in the Lord's strength, clothed in his armor, with respect to anything that comes against us. And many of the battles we face are waged within, in our hearts and minds. Anxieties, doubt, fear, emotional turmoil begin within. Sin begins within. Matthew 15:19. For out of the heart come evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, slanders. Before the deed is done, murder, immoral sex, lying, stealing, gossiping, whatever it is, it's been turning over and over in the heart and mind. It wasn't soldiered well in the heart and mind. So it grew and became something bigger. James 1:14-15, but each one is tempted when he is carried away and enticed by his own lust. Then when lust has conceived, it gives birth to sin. And when sin is accomplished, it brings forth death. Sin and death begin with our lusts. And where does lust begin? In the heart and mind. A longing, dwelling on what we desire. That lust didn't get checked. It wasn't soldiered well. So lust is conceived and gives birth to sin. If we know that the heart and mind are where much of the battle is, we have to get better about soldiering what's going on there. We can't be asleep on the post, because often we're fighting battles we don't have to fight. Sometimes we're fighting battles we've opened the door to. How to soldier the heart and mind. Let's talk about it. Number one, guard your heart. Proverbs 4:23, watch over your heart with all diligence, for from it flow the springs of life. When we think about being soldiers, words in the Bible like watch and guard hit us in a deeper way. In Nehemiah 4, the enemy was coming against the people of Israel, and it says they prayed and set up a guard against them day and night. An effective soldier is always on guard. We can't let just anything or anyone enter. You have to ask yourself things like, what am I watching? What am I listening to? What am I reading? These are the things that set up the flow of thoughts in your heart and mind. Who are you talking to? What's the conversation? Is it edifying or is it gossipy? Negative and critical, maybe immoral. Psalm 1, blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, nor stand in the path of sinners, nor sit in the seat of scoffers. Just being around in the path of certain people can put you at risk. You have to know what your heart and mind are sensitive to. And you have to stay on your post, ready to block certain people and things from entering in. Number two, stop owning your thoughts. As much as we want to guard our hearts, as careful as we may be, we know our thought life can get crazy. We're plagued with doubt, fear, anxiety, things from the past, thoughts that tempt us towards sin. And what we have to realize is, these are not all our thoughts. The enemy is shooting his thoughts into our minds all the time. He's making suggestions, enticing us. And whatever he stirs up is playing right into our minds because he knows us. But how often do you stop and say, wait a minute, why am I even thinking about this? This is not even my thought. Don't own those thoughts. They may sound like you, look like you, but they're not yours. Boot them out. And guess what? You don't have to own the ones that are yours. If they're filled with anxiety, doubt, and fear, if they're enticing you towards sin, that's your old nature. It's supposed to be dead. And this is a battle, right? Kill it and the thoughts that came with it. Number three, dwell on Philippians 4:8 things. Whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is of good repute, if there is any excellence, and if anything worthy of praise, dwell on these things. It's important to not just block the negative things from entering, but to also stay on offense. In Nehemiah, they had a guard in place day and night. Isn't it interesting that we're to meditate on the Word of God day and night? We have to be proactive about feeding our hearts and minds that which is true and pure, especially the Word of God. Last on the list, but first always, watch and pray. We're not soldiering anything well without prayer. If Jesus needed to pray during his time on earth, how could we think for a single moment that we could do without prayer? We know the battle within is real because Jesus dealt with it in the Garden of Gethsemane. Matthew 26, beginning at verse 36, then Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane and said to his disciples, sit here while I go over there and pray. And he took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee and began to be grieved and distressed. Then he said to them, my soul is deeply grieved to the point of death. Remain here and keep watch with me. The battle within is raging. Keep watch with me. Soldier with me. Stay on the post with me. And it says, and he went a little beyond them and fell on his face and prayed, saying, my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will. Notice he said, yet not as I will. There are times when we have to suffer hardship as a good soldier of Christ Jesus. It continues, and he came to the disciples and found them sleeping and said to Peter, so you men could not keep watch with me for 1 hour? Keep watching and praying that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. The book of Luke tells us they were sleeping from sorrow. They were dealing with their own battle within. But instead of watching and praying, instead of staying on their post, they went to sleep. But Jesus continued to pray. Jesus, our Lord and Commander, is our supreme example of how to soldier within. We pray, we trust the Father to accomplish his will, and we pray and pray some more. We should even pray for strength to keep praying. Guard your heart, stop owning all of your thoughts, dwell on Philippians 4:8 things, watch and pray. That is how we soldier our heart and mind. We can praise too. Hallelujah! That is the Lord who fights our battles.